The formal transition process of the newly appointed police officers took place today at the police headquarters in Naguru. It was presided over by Internal Affairs Minister Major General Kahinda Otafiire. Abbas Biakagaba and his deputy James Ochaya were the first to be adorned with their pips as a representation of their new ranks. Thereafter, the duo was officiated into their new responsibilities. IGP Biakagaba thanked President Museveni for entrusting him with the responsibility. He laid out the 9-point program on which he's going to operate, among which is improving the police and community relations, as well as training of officers. He said that fighting crime will be a top priority during his tenure.
That is the strength I'm going to be working with. Beyond myself, beyond the police, because I know it is out there, I must harness it. And we must harness it, colleagues. The police is stronger than the police. I want to say that. The police is stronger than the police. Because when you are looking at yourselves as the police, know that the other extra police is out there and ready to work with us.
The State Minister of Internal Affairs, General David Mohozi, urged the duo to promote the good image of police.
The President has now put you on test after a long period of midwifing. Please don't disappoint him. Acquit yourselves well. Lead well and even better. Build on the achievements this far and scale the heights to improve the force.
And on top of this, I present to you your service pistol. The service pistol you are carrying, you'll carry it forever as your weapon of protection until last post. You know what last post means? I don't take it. It will come back. That's when it will come back to the police. I did it to your predecessor. I want to do it to you. So that you remember you are a policeman. Policeman ad in eternum. Policeman for life.
The State Minister for Housing, Persis Namuganza, has come out strongly to condemn the soaring level of corruption in the country, which she says has led to loss of trust in the government. She shared her sentiments after pending her signature on the motion seeking to censure the embattled 4 parliamentary commissioners. Namuganza said if corruption is to be overcome, it has to start in parliament.
So some of us must show the population that we are not part. And the members of parliament who will refuse to sign this motion, I urge the public to vote them out, because that would be a signal to the population that they are corrupt and they support corruption.
She called upon other legislators to follow suit. The 4 commissioners accused of sharing 1.7 billion shillings are Matthias Mpoga, the Nyendo Mukunga Member of Parliament, Mbabazi Akamprira, the Rwanda Woman Member of Parliament, Esther Afoyochan, the Zombo Woman Member of Parliament, and Solomon Siranyi. Medical waste management is one of the growing problems in Bale City, raising concern in regard to health. This morning, the City Council, led by the Principal City Health Officer, Dr. Moses Mogonyi, introduced Orient Waste Management Company as the entity that will collect medical waste from various health facilities around the city.
As you've been moving around in Mbalise, we've been having a problem of waste generally. But the one which is very, very, very big concern to us as medical practitioners is what we generate from the healthcare facilities, and we call it medical waste. This medical waste is potentially infectious because it's contaminated with possibly disease-causing organisms. And the problem we've been having in the city is people have been accumulating this waste, then they go and dump it in the middle of roads, in the rivers, in the forests. And what pains me most is This waste, when it is dumped there, you find some people, especially children, they go and pick these needles and syringes and start playing with them. And even others, even puncture other children. And this is a potential for transmitting disease to these innocent people who have become just victims because somebody is carelessly dumping this medical waste in those bad places.
Segregation of waste, lack of waste management plans, inadequate waste management and coordination structure, ineffective and inefficient incineration equipment have been part of the growing problem. It remains to be seen if the introduction of this contractor will have a significant impact in combating the problem of medical waste in Imbale City.